Hello, I'm Dr. Deb, and I'm the department chair and instructor for learning strategies here at VC. In today's video, I'm explaining what metacognition is and how it can help you improve your learning and studying. VC's Total Learning Center presents Dr. Deb Explains Metacognition. Metacognition is thinking about your thinking. It's a bit more than, I think I'm hungry, or I think the Dairy Queen sounds really good right now. Instead, it's more along the lines of self-monitoring your thinking. Are you learning? How can you improve your learning? Are you taking the right steps and using the right tools to learn most effectively? Metacognition can be a difficult topic to understand as it's not something that you can touch and feel. It all takes place in your mind, so you can't see it, hear it, feel it, smell it. In order to help understand metacognition and what it looks like in practice, let's take a look at the Metacognitive Awareness Inventory. The Metacognitive Awareness Inventory is a list of 52 items that you answer true or false on, depending on if you do those items. For example, the last item is, I stop and reread when I get confused. If you do that, you would answer true, and if you don't, you would answer false. Now, this in itself is a good way to show what metacognition is and what it involves. These are the steps that students would take to be successful in college, and the act of thinking about whether or not they do these things while they are studying, or if they should be doing them, is practicing metacognition. So, for every false item, one could try to improve in that area by simply doing that item when studying in order to make it true. However, the assessment goes a bit further than that. It then asks you to break down your responses in two different categories: knowledge about cognition and regulation of cognition. This allows you to see what you know about thinking and learning and how you are regulating your thinking and learning. Knowledge about cognition is divided into three categories: declarative, procedural, and conditional. Declarative knowledge is factual knowledge. This is what you need to know before being able to do a process or to think critically. If you remember Bloom's taxonomy, this is the remembering and understanding levels that you need to know in order to do the upper levels of thinking. You need to know about, what, or that in order to operate at this level. Some examples include, I know what the teacher expects me to learn. I know what kind of information is most important to learn. I am good at remembering information. I am good at organizing information. Procedural knowledge is the application of knowledge for completing a procedure or process. It is knowing how to implement learning procedures or strategies. This is a third level of Bloom's taxonomy, applying. Some examples include, I try to use strategies that worked in the past. I am aware of what strategies I use when I study. Conditional knowledge is determining under what circumstances specific processes or skills should transfer. This connects to applying, but it involves knowing which processes to use and when to use them. For example, in math classes, you need to know which formulas to use on which problems. This is conditional knowledge because not all formulas will work with all types of problems. Some examples of this include, I learn best when I know something about the topic. I can motivate myself to learn when I need to. I know when each strategy I use will be most effective. The regulation of cognition has five parts that deal with the learning session: planning, information management strategies, comprehension monitoring, debugging strategies, and evaluation. The planning phase consists of planning, goal setting, and allocating resources before learning. This is what you do or should do before you actually begin studying or learning. It consists of things like, I set specific goals before I begin a task. I read instructions carefully before I begin a task. I organize my time to best accomplish my goals. The information management strategies are the skills and strategies that will be used to process the information more effectively: organizing, elaborating, summarizing. It includes items like, I try to break studying down into smaller steps. I focus on overall meaning rather than specifics. The comprehension monitoring stage involves assessing one's learning or strategy use. It has a great deal in common with self-monitoring. It includes items like, I ask myself periodically if I am meeting my goals. I find myself pausing regularly to check my comprehension. The next step is debugging strategies. These are strategies that you might use to correct comprehension and performance errors. What you would do if you realized you weren't learning, weren't understanding, etc. They include things like, I ask others for help when I don't understand something. I change strategies when I fail to understand. Finally, the last part is evaluation. This is the analysis of performance and strategy effectiveness after a learning session. It includes items like, I know how well I did once I finish a test. I summarize what I've learned after I finish. Metacognition can be a difficult topic to understand, but the Metacognitive Awareness Inventory provides students with actionable steps that they can take in order to monitor their comprehension as they are learning. Leave a comment below and tell me what you think about this assessment and ask me any questions that you have about it. If you want to know more about how to be a successful college student based on theories, strategies, and principles for college success, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell and check out my other videos as Dr. Deb Explains.